We have video two of the skateboard movie review. This is Plan B's True. And that just happened to rhyme.
Yay!
Anyways, so we got started off with a total newbie. We got a new guy, we got a new dog, we got fresh meat. But he gives himself a name, Chris Jocelyn. Starts off with some crazy bangers, some three flips, huge stuff. Then we have Scott DiCenzo, most likely related to Ryan DiCenzo. And you see some crazy stuff. What is it? One of which being a backsmith inward heel out from a picnic table. So that was very cool. And then you have Felipe Gustavo, who is the only person to have a rap song in the video. So that's nice. There's not many parts. It's more so that all the parts are long. Chris's part had Barracuda by Heart, which went very, very well with his part. Then we have, like I said, we have Scott DiCenzo, and then we have Felipe Gustavo, who had some big stuff, some flat ground tray flip to crook on a picnic table, top level. And then we have Pat Duffy, who did a lot of transition. Some pretty impressive stuff. Kickflip, nose slide in like a pretty, not vert quarter, but it didn't have much transition. It was like a ramp and then like a little quick up part. So to do something technical and that looked pretty difficult. Then you had, what is it? Oh, Elso and Philippe had some really crazy, like, vario flips, vario heels out, some very technical stuff. And, then we have, let's see here, I'm thinking, oh yeah, so Trent McClung came next, after Pat Duffy, and Trent McClung started off very interesting, riding down these wide stairs and doing these very long ledge hubba lines, which were very impressive, and it was a very interesting way to start it off, caught your attention, kept it, and the ender was insane, okay? So once you're done getting all hyped from Chris Jocelyn's part, now there's a lot of handrails in the video, that's okay, but there's also a lot of interesting places they do gaps. Then after Trent McClung, we have Ryan Sheckler, who, guess what? He didn't backside flip El Toro. Well, stay to the credits. You'll see, he did try, and you'll be like, holy shit. We get to see, now I don't know what happened with PJ Ladd, but he's not in the video. Danny Way isn't, Colin McKay's not, but we do get to see a very interesting trick that I've never seen before in vert, on this huge vert wall, and it's very cool, so you'll see, and you'll be like, wow. So Ryan's part was pretty cool. He had some interesting stuff, some stuff that I've never seen before, and it did impress me. I mean, I'm not a fan of Ryan Sheckler, but I do commend him on his part. Now, the ender, Tory Pudwill. Wow, man. I mean, he'd tray flipped out of like everything. Lots of lips, lots of back lips. There was some hand row stuff, which, I mean, it's not what I want to see Tori for. I want to see him doing some tech stuff. I'm not going to say, oh, I'm not going to talk shit about him, but it doesn't interest me seeing Tori Puddle do hand rows. But seeing him do, lip slide, tray flips out, off a ledge, that's cool. There was a lot of very techie stuff. Scott DiCenzo and Tori definitely took it. Chris Jocelyn had, I think, every type of trick on some huge, huge gaps. And the video was impressive. It's just compared to the girl videos, compared to the Black Label, the first two videos, it just, it doesn't. I'm not just like, I'm not like losing my shit, But Tori's part was very fucking impressive. Some very, very cool stuff. And one thing that I've never seen before. So there's some very, very cool stuff. All of the guys look like they worked their fucking asses off. Every part was very impressive. But the parts that stood out the most was Chris, Jocelyn, Scott DiCenzo, and Tori Pudwill. But for not backside flipping El Toro, Ryan did a pretty good job. But I gotta say, there is stuff you'll see in the film in the beginning, in the intro, that you're like, wait, whose part is that? So I don't know what happened with some of that, but it's a very impressive video. It's just not like the Girl Chocolate films or the first two Black Label films or Globe Opinion. There's some major, major tech stuff, but it's just the soundtrack and it just something about it, it didn't get up to those levels, I mean, Plan B has a legacy, from Secondhand Smoke, Virtual Reality. The other one, Secondhand Smoke, Virtual Reality. There's two other ones. Questionable, and there's one more. And those videos are fucking infamous because you have Ronnie Mullen, you have, I believe, Mike Carroll. Some very, very, very impressive dudes. And I think Guy Mariano is on there as well. Maybe. But just the 90s type of skating and those were just really just got you amped. But this video had some great, great tech stuff. But needing to own it, not really. It's just, there was so much like flip, 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 flip. You're like, whoa, the parts were really like cut quick and you might miss out some tricks. There were a lot of things that you're like, that's definitely NBD, but I don't know. It didn't have the magic like the Girl in Chocolate films do. Yeah, right. Pretty sweet. Goldfish, Mouse. So, anyways, very good video. That's Plan B True. And I'm look, you know, a lot of the dudes for Plan B weren't in it, which you're like, what? So I'm hoping the next skate video, Zero Fallen, the next DC video, we got Chris Cole, so we'll see who's gonna be in that part. And I look forward to a hopefully very, very, very epic next DC video. And I look forward to the next video part from a big company hopefully being awesome. So we'll see. Plan B True. Yes, it does exist. They have it on Netflix. That's how I watched it. So if you have Netflix streaming, definitely check it out. Again, Tori Pudwill, Scott DiCenzo, Chris Jocelyn's part, are the ones that you definitely need to see. Very, very, very cool. So.